Hey, it's Dan Wardrope here from Flexxable, and this video is for anyone who's struggling to bring their cost per lead down on YouTube. Okay, so they've made the transition over from Facebook to YouTube, but they just can't get it dialed in. And the reason I'm bringing this up is because I had a conversation with a student the other day. He's in the medical negligence space over in the States, doing exceptionally well on Facebook, tried to move over to YouTube using the same kind of creative and video that's been working on Facebook, but the cost per lead has been, you know, not where he needs it to be. There's been some leads coming in, but it's kind of triple, I guess, what it is on Facebook. So I jumped into his account. We went through it live and had a look at what was going on. And what the small thing that he didn't quite get right was that he checked the expanded audience interest when he was, not interest, the expanded audience checkbox. I'm gonna get my account manager to do a little video for you to show exactly where this is. So have a look at that now.
Hey guys, just a quick video here today. We've seen quite a few people not really knowing how to find the audience expansion area within YouTube, because some people have had it set to ticked on, and it just meant that a lot of spend has been going to this expanded audience and not the actual audiences you want to target. So it's just a quick video just to show you where to find it. So the first way is when you're creating a new campaign. So let's just let this go up. So yeah, do whatever you would do normally. Continue. And then, so this little audience expansion thing, just to show you. So you got to scroll down, it'll be in the audience section. So when you go to create your ad group, when you go to select an audience, it will be, so say, let's just do marketing. You want to make sure this is unchecked here, the audience expansion. You want to uncheck that. It can be a good tool to use down the road if you do want to expand your audience reach. But when you're starting out or you're testing audiences, it's very similar to Facebook. You want to just be testing that audience, really. You don't want to be expanding that audience. So that's when you're creating a campaign. If you've already set it up and you're not sure how to go check or turn it off, I'm just going to show you how to do it now. So you go into your campaign. You go to audiences. That's not good. Not a good example. That hasn't got an audience on it. You find a campaign that has an audience on it. That's a custom. This might not have one either. Just double check. It does. Okay, cool. So you'd be on that. You would click into the campaign. You come to this screen here. You'd want to go to audiences, and then you want to click this blue pencil here. And you have to do it for each ad group. So select which ad group you want to do it for. And then the audience expansion will be here. And if it's ticked, you want to uncheck it. But if you want to go in and add it, then this is where you'd add it as well. You just check that button. But when you're starting out, you want to make sure that this isn't checked. So always double check that. And if you want to find out if it is spending on expansion, let me just... I know there was one which we had on expansion, bear with. Here it is. So if you want to double check if your audiences are spending on expansion, again, you want to go to the audience section within your campaign, and it should say here. So it's all total audiences. That's what was spent on the audiences. And this was the total spent on the expansion. So as you can see, sometimes it is beneficial to expand it, but most of the time it's not. It's only on certain kind of countries or things like that. But that's how you can see if you're spending too much on the expansion of that audience. So at least it does tell you the members of the audience that were targeted and the members of the expansion of the audience that were targeted.
So now you know where it is. This is something that you need to uncheck when you're getting your campaigns dialed in. Okay, so this guy is an exceptionally smart marketer, doing very well, and he created five custom mix between custom intent and custom affinity audiences, and he kept this box checked. And the problem is that we went and had a look at his stats and where all the traffic was coming from, and not one of the clicks or impressions was coming from the audiences that he was asking Google to show his ads to, which meant that obviously the cost per lead was high and his audience wasn't dialed in at all. Okay, so that's a quick tip that's going to help you. Okay, if you are struggling with YouTube, so I'm actually looking for a small group of people, about five people, to do exactly this, that are struggling to get their YouTube cost per lead dialed in. We can catch up on a weekly basis and have a look at exactly what we can do. We can review your screen and all that type of stuff and help you get YouTube dialed in, or any other traffic network for that matter. So if you're interested, comment below this video. And also my helper, Natalie, will be here to kind of see if it's a good fit and see if you can kind of, you know, whether we can get you results, okay, which is the most important thing. You know, my personal help, I don't want to give it lightly. So if we can't get you dialed in, then probably not going to be a good fit. So natalie@flexxdigital.com, if you want to email her, that's flexxdigital.com. There'll be probably my video person will put an email address there. Or just comment below the video and we can take it from there. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it makes a difference to your YouTube cost per lead. And I'll speak to you soon.